Hey, TechKnowSurge. I've been really looking forward to this module and especially this video. In this video, we're gonna be covering all about public key infrastructure, and we're gonna get pretty in depth into it. We're gonna talk about a lot of the components around public key infrastructure, and we're gonna talk about the process that it uses to verify a site. Now, public key infrastructure is not a end-all be-all. That is, that there are still ways to trick people into going into the wrong sites. However, what this does is it really does a lot of safeguarding to make sure that we make it to the right site and that site is verified and that site has a certain amount of encryption and security back and forth. So let's get into this video. Let's get into depth into what public key infrastructure is and how it works. Really, I'm most excited about getting into the process. That is how PKI works to verify these different sites. But before we do that, we need to make sure we have a good foundation. So because of that, I'm gonna start out with just talking about public key infrastructure, what it is, what its goals are. I'm gonna give a little demo so we have a visual and we can visualize it as we're going through this process. I'm gonna talk about different elements, just a brief overview of the public key cryptography, digital certificates, hashes, certificate authority, registration authority, and CA certificates. I cover some of these more in depth into other videos, so I'm just going to give a brief highlight on what these concepts are. Then we're going to get into the verification step. We'll talk about installed certificates and take a look at those, and then we'll get into that process and what the in-process looks like. So what is public key infrastructure? It really is all about managing these digital certificates. Managing the digital certificates that help us verify sites, help us verify authenticity with all sorts of data communication. And so that is what public key infrastructure is. It's all the documentations, it's all the standards, it's all the different processes that this goes through, it's all of the servers, it's all the applications that goes into managing these digital certificates. There are a lot of different applications when it comes to PKI. Things like digital signatures or code verification. There's a lot of areas that we can actually apply this to. But essentially, it all revolves around communication. Communication between possibly an end user and some sort of service that they're trying to access. That they're not being redirected to another set of servers here that are mimicking these servers to trick that user. We want a certain amount of authenticity that is coming from the source that it should be coming from. I'm on a browser and I'm on the TechKnowSurge.com website. Specifically, this is the newsletter sign up. And the thing is that anybody could actually mimic this page right here. They could even mimic the URL. That's really easy to do. But I know this is coming from the actual TechKnowSurge.com. And I know that because of this lock that appears to the left-hand side. Whenever you see the lock to the left of the URL, it's telling you two different things. Number one is it's telling you that wherever you're at, in this case it's TechKnowSurge.com, that is the actual TechKnowSurge.com, that you're on the actual site. The other thing that it's telling you is that you have a secure communication between that site and your browser. And that's important because you don't want anybody to alter this information or change the code, therefore compromising this site. So it is secure, it's encrypted back and forth. And I can actually see more details. If I click on this lock, it says connection is secure, and I can click on that to find out more. It says certificate is valid, and I can actually open up the certificate. The certificate is what's actually validating the authenticity of the site, that it's actually coming from the TechKnowSurge.com servers. And it verifies this is from the TechKnowSurge.com, and it's verifying it through Let's Encrypt. We're going to talk more about that through the rest of this video. Oh, by the way, this is the TechKnowSurge newsletter. We release awesome content on a regular basis, so make sure you sign up for our newsletter. So before we go into the really cool process of how it does that verification, let's start out by just going over a few elements that it uses to make sure that we have that base foundation. I'm gonna real quickly go over this because I do cover this much more in depth in other videos. So first of all, it does use public key cryptography. Public key cryptography is that public-private key pair, and you can encrypt a message with a private key and decrypt it with a public key. So that's really critical to this whole process. There's also a digital certificate. I showed you one and an example on that browser that I just had up. And so the digital certificate has some information in it. Well, number one, it has the public key. So what you're receiving is not actually just the public key by itself. You're receiving the digital certificate, which has the public key inside of it. You also have a lot of information like when does this key expire and what site is it for and who is it verified by. Public key infrastructure also utilizes hashes. Hashes is that one-way algorithm that you get a unique fingerprint from data. So we can pump in a bunch of data. So in this case right here, it's actually pumping in all of the data of this certificate, and it's going into a fingerprint that's included then on the certificate. And that fingerprint is a representation of all of the data that's inside of that certificate. Public key infrastructure utilizes a certificate authority. A certificate authority is going to be a third party that's going to be the one that is actually going to verify a server. That is, this user wants to make sure that they're accessing the correct server. But how is it going to trust a server that it's never accessed before? Well, what's going to happen is this user is going to trust the certificate authority. And if the user trusts the certificate authority and the certificate authority trusts this set of servers right here, then this user will trust this server right here. And so that's what the certificate authority is there for. It's that verification step. So how would a certificate authority trust some sort of servers or some sort of source of this? Well, what's going to happen is we're actually going to use a registration authority. This set of servers is going to turn in some data into a registration authority, and that registration authority is going to go through a process to confirm that this is legitimate. And from there, then once this registration authority gives the thumbs up to the CA will then trust this server. It looks a little different actually when we get into the process, but essentially that's what's happening here. There is another certificate that's involved here, and I want to cover what that certificate is. It's the one from the certificate authority. And so what that looks like here is we have a certificate here. We have a certificate from TechKnowSurge.com. That certificate has the public key that aligns with the private key of these servers right here, the TechKnowSurge.com servers. And so that is one certificate that we're going to be looking at. But there's another one here. There's a certificate that's actually already on your computer that's coming from some sort of root certificate authority here that has a public key that aligns with a private key of a certificate authority. So how do we go through this verification? Well, really, there are two things that we need to verify in this process. First of all, we need to verify this digital certificate to make sure that it's authentic, that this is the website, this is the public key associated with that website, and this is all of the information that's associated with that digital certificate. Make sure that that digital certificate is authentic. So that's the first thing. And then secondly is the data that comes to us, we want to verify that that data is authentic. So how are we going to verify a certificate? And really what we have here was within the certificate, it's got a lot of different information, of which one of it is, what is the certificate authority? This user, this machine already trusts this certificate authority. In fact, it already has the certificate associated with that certificate authority on that machine already. And it within there is the public key that's associated with the private key from that certificate authority. What has happened ahead of time is that on here, the fingerprint for this digital certificate was encrypted with this private key. So now if I use this public key to decrypt this fingerprint, and then I can perform another hashing algorithm on the rest of the certificate to find out the fingerprint of the certificate that I was given. And if these two are equal, then I know that this digital certificate was encrypted with the key associated with the public key that I have that I know that I can trust. And so therefore, now I can trust this certificate. So the second step to this is verifying the traffic that's actually coming to me. And I can do this actually pretty easy because now I trust this certificate. I can use this public key right here to decrypt the data. And if that data gets decrypted correctly, then I know that it's been encrypted with the proper private key, meaning that it came from the proper source. Okay, time for the main event. Let's summarize this all up, and we're gonna talk about the process now. I have the TechKnowSurge website that's being hosted on some servers. I wanna make sure users that are getting to my site can make sure that they're getting the correct information, that it's both secure and coming from the accurate source. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna, first of all, generate a key pair. That is gonna be a private and a public key. I'm going to take the public key and I'm going to turn that into a CSR, which is a certificate signing request. This is what I'm going to actually use to make a request for a digital certificate. The next step in the process is take that CSR that has the public key in it and turn it into the registration authority, the RA. So often that looks like you're just going to a CA and turning it into the CA. And the CA has some sort of built-in RA involved in it. But the big key here is that you are going to have to verify who you are. That not anybody can just say, yeah, I'm technosurge.com and get a certificate for that site. Not just anybody can do that. They have to go through some verification that they actually own that domain. So once that domain has been verified, that CSR gets turned into the certificate authority. That certificate authority is going to generate a certificate. The certificate includes things like the URL, includes information about the certificate authority, includes the public key. It has a lot of information within that certificate authority. Then what it will do is it'll create a hash of that information, that fingerprint of all of that information. Then it will encrypt that hash and put it back onto the certificate. Now that encrypted fingerprint is on the certificate. That certificate then gets shipped back to the requester, whoever turned that CSR in, and then that certificate gets installed onto this server. So now this server has the private key that it originally had with a certificate that includes the public key and now the encrypted fingerprint that was encrypted using the CA. And so what happens is now a user will connect to the website. And one of the things that it will download is this certificate. So now this user has this certificate. Then what that computer would do is it would then hash the information within that certificate, creating that unique fingerprint. It could also take the public key from that certificate authority and decrypt the fingerprint that's on that digital certificate. And as long as these two fingerprints match now, then it knows that it's been encrypted with this private key that is from that trusted source. And so therefore, then this is a verified certificate. So now all we need to do is verify the traffic. And we do that by when the traffic comes in, we can decrypt it with this public key. As long as we can decrypt it with the public key, we know that it's been encrypted with the associated private key. So one thing to note is that these private keys need to stay private. That is that this private key that's associated with these services that are being provided, if that were to ever get out, and then somebody could use that to set up a parallel system and be able to trick end users into thinking that that is the actual site. And that could be devastating to the end users, and it could be devastating to you, your company or your organization or whatever website that this is hosting for. So it's really important that you keep these private keys private. So one of the questions might be is, okay, this is the public key infrastructure. It does authenticity to verify where the source is, where it's coming from. And so where do we use this? Well, there are a lot of places we can use this. Websites and web services was my primary example right here, but it could be used with apps and APIs and emails and digital signatures and code signing and federation services, VPNs. There's just a whole host of different ways that we can actually use this for authenticity purposes. So a ton of information there, but really cool stuff on how PKI works. We started out just talking about some generalities about public key infrastructure and the goals of it and a little demo and saw what it looked like in the browser. But then we dove deep into the elements of PKI because it really uses a lot of cryptography. It uses those public key and cryptography. It uses hashes. It uses those digital certificates, those certificate authority and registration authority. It uses all those individual components. And then we talked about that process and the process of how it goes about actually doing the verification. First, the verification of the digital certificate, then the verification of the traffic that's coming into that end user. And then finally, we wrap things up by talking about some of the uses of PKI. There's actually more to public key infrastructure. So we're going to actually get more into different elements of public key infrastructure to really analyze it from every different aspects and get a little more granular into how public key infrastructure works. So I look forward to joining you in the next set of videos.